I filmed this video a while back and realized I had not edited and posted it, so I thought I would do that real quick. I'm painting some oyster shells and I'm going to make Christmas ornaments out of them. This Art Deco silver white paint is really, really translucent. It is not a solid color at all. And I just wanted to do something really simple and elegant. And painting these oyster shells just is almost like a really pearlescent color. And it looks like I lost a shell somewhere along the way. I have no idea where that fifth shell is. I'm going to put my mermaid trash along the bottom edge of each one of these shells. The two shells to the right, I am using Aline's clear tacky glue to attach my mermaid trash. And if you don't know, my mermaid trash is a concoction that I've made from chunky sand from my beach, crushed glass, and glitter in little teeny tiny shells. Then the two shells to the left, and I'm just using Play-Doh to kind of level out these shells. So the two shells to the left, I'm using Mod Podge to attach the mermaid trash. And this really is kind of a test to see if, which method works better. Both the Mod Podge and the tacky glue work great for securing the mermaid trash, and I'm really happy. So now it is on to the next step, which is adding resin. And I pre-mixed my KSRESIN liquidy split. And then I'm adding a little drop of the liquid resin dye in turquoise blue to the cup. Well, the first shell on the right, I just added clear. And then I added the liquid resin dye to the cup, turquoise blue. Mixing it up, and I'm adding that to each one of the shells. And then I'm spreading the resin around so that it colors the whole shell, and that the excess, the resin is self-leveling. So the excess is going to pool down into the lowest part of the shell, which is what I wanted, so that it looks like an ocean. I think it looks really cool. I don't know if I mentioned it, but I'm using KS Resin Liquidy Split. It is my absolute go-to. Putting a little bit of excess resin on that one shell that I added the clear, and then I'm just taking my heat gun to pop any bubbles and to kind of spread things out a little bit. The next day, once everything was cured, I'm using less resin, UV resin, that I got on Amazon. The link is in the description. And I'm going to secure a couple of these little charms. And I don't know why I didn't do that when I had the KS resin on there. Probably because I didn't have enough resin to do the shells and do the charms. But you know what? The UV resin works really, really great as an adhesive as well as for jewelry and everything. So I tend to use it as glue sometimes. But you do have to make sure that you leave your lamp on for a long enough time so that everything cures fully and cures properly. Because sometimes if you're using it on a solid surface and the lamp can't get all the way through to the bottom of where the UV resin is. I hope I'm explaining that right, but you might end up with, something that's a little tacky. Now that everything is done, I'm turning them over and I'm going to attach a little raffia ribbon with hot glue so that we have a hanger so that these ornaments can be hung on a Christmas tree or on a doorknob or as a gift tag, whatever. I've even seen people use them as little gift tags on a wine bottle. Here they are, all finished. I'm really happy with them. I hope you learned something new. If you have any questions, leave me a comment and I'll be sure to respond. Thanks so much for watching and happy crafting. Bye-bye.